Let's talk about events. It is called event groups within FreeRTOS API and event flags within CMC's OS version 2. It is not implemented within CMC's OS version 1. Event allow a task to wait for a combination of one or more events. Once an event occurs, it may unblock all the tasks that are waiting for it. Of course, if the tasks are not waiting for more than one event. As a result, unblocked task is moved from blocked to ready state. Events code is stored within event underscore groups.c file and event underscore groups.h file, which needs to be added to the code once we plan to use them. It requires some additional FreeRTOS components to be fully operational. We will describe it in next slides. Once you are generating code from STM32 CubeMX or CubeIDE, those two files are added automatically once you generate even the simplest code based on FreeRTOS. It requires creation of like most OS components. So to use events, we need to create a separate OS component like we're doing within semaphores or queues. And this object has its own control block to store its configuration and status. Events are supported within CMC's OS version 2 as event flags and within FreeRTOS API as event groups. What are the main advantages of events? It is allowing to reduce RAM usage by replacing various combinations of semaphores. It is simplifying the synchronization among the tasks by waiting for a combination of events. It allows to be read by multiple tasks which are waiting for the information. It allows to use broadcasting mechanisms within operating system, and it can be used within other tasks and interrupts. Event groups are using 16 or 32-bit long variables to store events. So each event means one bit set within this variable. This variable is defined within event underscore groups.c file as event bits underscore t, and it can be 16-bit value without sign if config use 16-bit ticks is defined within FreeRTOS config.h file. It will be 32-bit long without sign otherwise. Most significant 8 bits within this variable are called control bits and are defined as event bits control bytes. Those are blocked for the control data passed via event functions. The role of the control bits is the following. Event wait for all bits means that we are waiting for all of the bits from the specified mask. If it's cleared, event flags will be satisfied if any of the bit from the mask will be set. Event unblocked due to bit set mask, it means that once it is set, it means that the task waiting for event flags has been unblocked due to its required bit matching, not due to timeout. And the last one, event clear events on exit bits, it means that all bits within the masks will be cleared on successful exit of this function. So once the bit flag mask will be set. Let's have a look at some differences among different APIs concerning group events. In FreeRTOS, this mechanism is called event group. In CMC's OS version 1, it is not implemented. And in CMC's OS version 2, which we are describing within this session, it is called event flags. And as in other CMC's OS functions, there is no different function for thread and IRQ execution. It is checked within the function and proper FreeRTOS API call is done. We will focus on CMC's OS version 2 of this implementation. So let's have a closer look at event flags. Let's have a look at attributes of event flags specified within OS event flags 8tr underscore t type. It is defined within CMC's underscore os2.h file. The only one we need to specify manually is the name of the event flag. The rest, like attribute bits, pointer to the control block memory area, and control block size, will be filled automatically after creation of the object. How we need to create the flags objects? So, for this we've got a dedicated function osEventFlagsNew, which is requiring from us one argument, which is the pointer to the structure with the attributes of the event flags object we would like to create. In fact, we can specify only the name, So in case we don't want to spend time for this, we just put null within the pointer, and in this case the default values would be set. The function is returning back the handler to event flags, which can be used later on to pass the event flags or to wait for them within other functions. To delete event flags, we need to use the function osEventFlagsDelete. It is requiring one argument, which is the handler to event flags objects, and it returns the variable osStatus_t. If it's 0, means that the function has been executed correctly. If it's minus, it is, if there is, let's say, some other value lower than 0, it means that some errors occurred during this process. To set bitmask, we need to call osEventFlagsSet function. It requires two arguments: a handler to event flag and 32-bit value with event bitmask to be set. Please remember that we mustn't use highest 8-bit of this mask, as those are reserved for the control bits. Setting bits in an event group is not a deterministic operation, because there are known number of tasks that may be waiting for the bit or bits being set. FreeRTOS doesn't allow non-deterministic operations to be performed in interrupts or from critical sections. Therefore, X event group set bits from ISR send a message to the timer task to have the set operation performed in the context of the timer task, where a scheduler lock is used to place it for a critical section. To use this, we need to enable X event group set bits from ISR within include parameters at FreeRTOS configuration. This is why, if you would like to use event groups and you would like to set some event groups within interrupts, you need to enable as well the software timers. To clear a mask, there is a dedicated function osEventFlagsClear, which requires two arguments: handler of the event flag object and bitmask to be cleared. Please remember to not use highest 8 bits. In both cases, functions return 32-bit signed value. It contains event flags content after the operation, or in case of an error, its code. This code could be OS error parameter, which is the bitmask when the bitmask is not in proper size. So for example, we were trying to use the highest 8 bits. And the second error code could be OS error resource, in case the resource was not available. Both components have a negative value by origin, because those are coming from osStatus_t, and in this case both are casted to unsigned 32 bits. To wait for specific bitmask within selected event flags object, we need to call osEventFlagsWait function. It cannot be run from interrupt, as it is blocking function and we cannot block the interrupt. Arguments we need to pass to these functions are the following: event flags handler, bitmask, which the task is waiting for, and options. Those options could be OS flags wait all, it is 1 in hexadecimal, and it means that we need to wait for all specified bits within the bitmask. The second option, which can be ORed with the previous one, is OS flags no clear. This is 2 hexadecimal, and it means that event flags bits should be not cleared on exit of this function. The last fourth argument for this function is a maximum timeout in milliseconds to wait for the event flags being set. Function is returning unsigned 32-bit value, which contains either event flags value in case of successful execution, or the error code casted from int 32 bits into unsigned int 32 bits value. And it can be one of the values: OS error ISR in case of calling this function from interrupt, which is not allowed; OS parameter error parameter in case of taking into account most significant 8 bits, which are reserved for the control bits; OS error timeout in case event flags bit mask is not set within given timeout; and OS error resource in case it was not possible to access event flags object. An important component within event flags and software timers, which would be described in separate section, is so-called RTOS agent task. Originally it was used to execute software timer callback functions, now it is used to other components like event flags. Its priority is set within config timer task priority, its stack size is set within config timer task stack depth, and it is necessary to define config use timers and include xtimer pend function call within FreeRTOS config.h file to generate this function. What is important is to set properly especially the priority of this agent task to allow it execution among other tasks which are active in the system. Otherwise, it may happen that it will be blocked, so our event flags would be not serviced properly within the system. Below, there is an example of additional configuration of FreeRTOS.h file in order to use event flags from interrupts, because this RTOS agent, which we discussed on the previous slide, is used mainly to service the event flags from interrupts. So in our example, we need to define config use timers to 1, it means that it's enabled, then config timer task priority, by default it is 2, so once you create an example, please unify this value to the priorities used in your example. Then config timer queue length is set to 10, it has more importance within software timers, when you can have multiple software timers and then you need some queue to store the commands sent by various timers. In case of event flags, it is not that important, so we can keep default value, and then config timer task stack depth, it's 256, which is quite enough for this. And then we need to enable the include xtimer pend function call. To enable it, we need to set it to 1. Above configuration is enabled and forced by default when we are using CMC's OS version 2, but we need to enable everything when using, for example, CMC's OS version 1. Important message once again is to update the RTOS agent task priority within config timer task priority value versus other tasks priorities in the system, so there would be a possibility to execute it.
Thank you for watching this video.